Just tell us what personal rapid transit is all about. Why is it more efficient than, say, like a subway or a bus?
Well, good morning, Caroline. Thank you so much for letting me be here and speak with you. So what we do is the exact opposite of a bus or a train. Rather than cramming lots of people into one vehicle that stops from stop to stop to stop, and you have to wait on it, we bring vehicles to you. Every passenger gets their own vehicle on demand, anytime, 24/7, and that vehicle only stops once it's on its journey, which is at your destination. Mm. And so we're inverting the paradigm of shared vehicles to private vehicles. But ironically, we can move more people that way at a fraction of the cost.
Interesting. It kind of makes me think of the Minority Report, where we kind of saw Tom Cruise breaking out of one. But these ideas have been long in the making. In fact, I think it's London Heathrow's had them for a while, so has Dubai. Why hasn't it sort of picked up in mass?
They have been. The idea of PRT, personal rapid transit, has indeed been around for a very long time, but no one could make it work. And frankly, we have to thank the $100-odd billion of VC capital that went into autonomous vehicle technology, which, while it isn't ready, it has provided the platform to make a closed, autonomous personal rapid transit system like ours work and work really, really well.
So you're authorized for pre-development agreement. What
That's
next?
Right.
What about environmental engineering reviews and the likes?
Well, that's precisely what's next. But because we're a fraction of the size of a traditional rail system, for example, we're also at a fraction of the cost and a fraction of the time. So we're going to go through environmental reviews next, but at a fairly rapid clip, just because our footprint is so much smaller. And then we're going to build it. But again, building it happens in a matter of months, not typically decades or maybe even longer than that in some instances.